Welcome to Buy Fun with Shruti. So in today's video, I'm going to show you how to make some flowers with a wool, especially to say leftover wool. So for this, you need some strings. Apart from the strings, you require some wool. And after the wool, the most important thing is green plaster, which you'll get in every bookshop easily. So let's start the video. So in order to make the flower, I'll start with gray, right? So I'll take one end of the spool and I'm just going on rolling it, right? I'll roll. So we are making tiny flowers, so I'm just rolling using a single finger, right? Try to make as many rolls as possible so that your flower looks really fluffy and good, right? Yes, I think it's enough now. I'm going to cut it. And after cutting it, please remove this carefully and gently and especially with patience. After you remove this, right, like this I got. So take a piece of string. This I have already removed. Means I have made a cut. So I'm inserting this string exactly through the middle. As it is little fluffy, it is not going exactly through the middle. Yes, finally I got it. Now, I am going to make this string bend a little like this. And then you're going to fold these parts together like this. Right? You're going to secure it. By just like this. Right, the string is very delicate so that it can mold accordingly. So now you are left with some portion, something like this. So the extending thread part you can cut to the height of the flower. So you can cut it till here, this extending part, so that it will be equal in height with other. Right, so now you are left with this structure. Now what you have to do, insert your scissor from all these loops and make a cut. Like this, right? And search for any other loops which are left and then pass your scissor again and then cut again, right? Like this. So now you are left with some creepy structure like this. So this is not the flower I thought of making. Yes, so somehow you will be left with, right, you'll be left with a structure like this, right? Now what we have to do is to take a comb or a brush and try to comb away these particles like this, right? I'll try to make it so that it will not look, yes, right? Comb this side as well. Right. Once the combing is done, we are left with some structure like this. Now what you have to do, you have to trim the edges nicely so that you'll get a good flower. Also trim the edges of the flower like this, and whatever standing parts of the flower are there, standing parts of the hair like this, just keep on trimming. And you will know when you're making your own flower, now you'll know how to trim it, how to make it and how to adjust it. I am making summer cutting for this flower. Yes. Okay, so jokes apart, something like this you will get. And you can do better trimming. Right. Right. So this is our ultimate flower like this. Right. So it's so beautiful. Just let me remove the trash here and so that I can show you clearly. Right, so this is the flower. Now what we are going to do, we are going to take this green plaster and we are just simply going to roll it over here. Make sure that you are making some 3-4 rolls here itself, because it appears as the scientifically speaking thalamus of the flower. But I know there are other subscribers who will be mad at me if I use the scientific names, right? So however it is, the base of the flower will be lightly swollen, right? So we'll make a few rolls here and then keep on rolling, keep on rolling, keep on rolling, keep rolling. Yes, keep on rolling, rolling, rolling. So here, in order to make this little stronger, I decided to go on a second round, and moreover this plaster started turning in weird ways. Especially when I'll do the video, plaster starts irritating me. Fine. Yes, we'll have one more roll so that it'll be safe and secure. Right. Serious this time, huh? Yes, perfect. 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 Perfectly done. Yes. Now cut it. Yes, you are left with a beautiful structure like this, and this is irritating me a lot, so I'm removing this part. Yes, yes, yes. Fine. Now you're left with a beautiful flower like this, right? Okay, so I have made several buds like this. So I'll also show you how to make the bud. And these are again some of the flowers that I have made. So let's make another bud. For making the bud, I already had, I'm already having these pom-pom balls which I ordered online. So you can prepare it by yourself or at home using the same wool. Several websites on YouTube show you how to prepare a pom-pom ball, this thing, right? As far as my pom-pom ball, these buds are concerned, I just took the string and inserted this into a pom-pom ball. As it came out like this, I again reinserted it into this so that the ball stays secured, right? And I pulled it further inside so that it will not be visible from the top. And now what I did, I took the green plaster and I started to paste the green plaster here like this so that it looks like a real bud. Yes, I told you the green plaster is very sensitive. It knows everything when I'm taking a video, and it never fails to irritate me, right? Yes, where is my bud? Where is the bud? Yes, here. Okay, so we are going to paste it, right? You need to stretch the plaster and then turn the string like this, so that it gets nicely wrapped like this. That's it. So there we are done with the bud. So I took a central stalk like this. I made it by just keeping 4-5 strings together. And to this, now we are going to first of all take the middle part of the branch and start wrapping it with a plaster so that it looks like a same branch, right? And I'm going to seal the part from every end. So so that it everything looks like a simple single one, and make sure that do you're doing it tight, a little bit tighter, so that later what happens, these things they come out, they start coming out. So make sure that you're doing it little tight like this. So now that becomes the first part. So the more plaster you keep, the more tight it will be. So once this is done, cut this plaster over here, and then we'll move on with the second part. The second part can also be adjusted somewhere here, but before that we'll do with this flowers. So as you can see, more buds here, you can keep a flower here like this part, and you can keep one bud some more somewhere here down. And first make sure that you're keeping a plaster over here now, so that you secure the position of the flower like this. So we'll keep a plaster right from here. Later we can secure the bud like this. So bud obviously gets removed when I'm securing the flower, right? And now let's secure the bud somewhere here. Right, cut this. Then the most interesting part is this. So what you have to do, and make sure that you're making this part, like this. Right, make sure that you're just making one twist is enough, because anyhow you're going to secure it with a plaster, right? Make sure that every side you're having a flower and every side you're having one bud, so this way it doesn't look empty anywhere. You can make several such flowers, as I'm not having I'm running out of time, so I thought I'll just make you this one central part and I'll show you. Later you can extend it by using your own creativity. Like this. One round done, one more round, and then we are done with our craft for today. For this, a dramatic flower vase will be very nice. So dramatic in the sense which is dull and bold, because the flowers are dull but they're having so much of beauty in them. So this represents the dull and boldness, right? And then here we go with our craft. So this is today's craft. We'll adjust it according to the beauty as we require. So this, we are done. I am using this flower vase, and you can keep it like this. So let me show you how does it really look. So this is our final look. Hope everyone you like it. Keep stay tuned to Bifon with Shruti for more such lovely videos. Thank you.